Okay, so let's understand about, before we proceed forward, let's understand about Admin Studio, which has been provided in Pega. So this portal has been added from Pega 8.1 onwards. From Pega 8.1 onwards, this was added. So in place of this, we used to have what? Summer Online or offline. SMA, that is called System Management Application. So if you want to see SMA, how it looks like, options, everything is same, 99%. If you want to see how SMA is available in before versions and all, how it looks like, what options available, same options mostly, you can go to my YouTube channel and find out a video on SMA. You should see how it was there in Pega 7 and before versions. Now let's go over here. Admin Studio, switch to Admin Studio here. Go to Admin Studio. When you go to Admin Studio here, this is Admin Studio resources. See, Admin Studio purpose. What is the purpose of Admin Studio? Admin Studio purpose is to manage. Manage what? Is to manage. You can see here. Requesters. What else? Jobs, this is a future enhancement. Queue process, queuing, I'll tell you. Listeners, what listeners? N number of listeners are there, different listeners, file listeners, JMS, email, etc. MQ, I'm not pretty sure about MQ. MQ is service, I believe. Here you go. Next one, most important is agents, agent queue management. And node classification. Node means it's a server in a cluster. Okay, logging management can be done, and APIs. So this APIs related to APIs, all are REST API. So the purpose of APIs, let me write down here for your information as of now. There are a lot many purposes, but I'm writing whatever that I remember. Purpose of APIs is clear cache memory logs management or something. Logs management is not already, maybe, etc. Something you can do. I'll show you. All these APIs are RESTful protocol. I'll tell you whenever we come across. Now let's go ahead and proceed forward. So if you go to requester management, these are the requesters. Go to requester management, these are the requesters. What is this requester ID? What are these requesters? We are going to talk about now. So understanding requesters. So the other batch people, you can see now. Understanding requesters. This is the purpose of SMA. I mean, like Admin Studio. We'll be using this going forward, Admin Studio and all. So next 15 minutes, I'll tell you understanding requesters in Pega. See, whenever an operator log into PRPC, a requester session will get created with a unique requester ID generated, which is hexadecimal. How many characters? I believe it is 32 digits. You can read it. I'm not very much sure. So whenever there is any requester login, suppose you are an operator, if you log into PRPC, for you a session will be created and there will be an ID that will be created in the system. Similarly, a number of people log into server, for all of them requester sessions will be created, their IDs will be generated. All the requesters can be seen, can be managed using requesters wizard in Admin Studio. Admin Studio, that is SMA in before version. Look at here. If you go to requesters here, these are the requesters that are being displayed. So is the requester always a human requester? always a human. Then what are the types of, generally it's not instead of human requester, human in the sense browser, a human interacts with an application by using a browser. Browser request is the one. Other than this, what are the other sources that makes requests to an application? Those who are already working in any technology should be able to tell me.
Absolutely.
It can be services, some third party application using a web service call can enter into your application as a requester. Third party applications, what else?
Web service agents.
Third party applications using web services.
Agents.
Yeah, it can be an internal background processes which runs in the same system. In the same server, there can be internal background processes that you can design at a schedule basis or something. It will wake up, it will do process something internally in the same server. It is a kind of schedule, job scheduling. Okay, so that can be a requester. For that request session will be created. What else? Other requesters can be portals. Look at here. The requester name starts with B, starts with A, requester name starts with H, requester name starts with, you will not see this regularly, P. Starts with P. Types of requesters. Four. How many types? Four types. Requester names generally starts with these characters. What are the characters? H, B, A, what else? P. H means, you can understand, what is the abbreviation of H? Can be human. H means browser. Humans are going to use browsers. B means batch. This is internal jobs like agents. Okay, next, what is the other one? A means applications. Applications means services. Next, P means portals. It can be a portal request from third party system to your portal. Okay, like when you are using direct web access, mega mesh, some concept is there. Using that, then it's a different case. Portals you will not see generally here. Okay, so these are the types of requesters that are available. Apart from this, here you go, listeners and all, I will tell you whenever working with listeners, see, a requester can be dismissed at any moment of time. You can go ahead and open the requester where it is available. Yeah, a requester can be traced, a requester can be terminated. These are the main options that we can see. Interrupt means you can pass it. So a requester can be traced. This is called remote tracing. Suppose you log in, you can trace other requester sessions. This is called remote tracing. Generally, if you log into BRPC and open tracer, tracer will have same session as your request ready, right? But remote tracer session will be remote requester, some other requester session. I will tell you that. I will show you practically how to do tracing. Requester can be traced. What else? Stopped. That is what terminated, right? Terminated, etc. You can do. You can see the options there. In the screen, like this, you can go ahead and use requesters. Now, in the next class, we are going to talk about background requesters. Background requesters are agents. You know human requesters. Today, next 9 minutes, I'll tell you something about remote tracing. Remote tracing. What do you mean by remote tracing? You can understand from this word remote tracing itself. What do you mean by remote tracing? This means tracing of a remote requester. Means you log in and you trace your colleague's work. Your colleague, whatever that he is executing, suppose if you want to trace, you have to go ahead and use remote tracing. See, look at here. Whenever you go to the requester management, Just let me check the more columns. PEGA, status, license, threads, archive, something like that. Okay. See here, operator ID. So operator ID will have an operator ID value only for what type of requests? Browser requests. Browser means which will start with H. Batch processing and web services, portals. All these will not be having operator IDs because those are from third party systems or those are internal to PEGA. So those will not have any requester IDs being created. Okay. You will see for all of them, none. But only for human request, that is a browser request, you will see operator ID. That means any human login, we can understand in the request environment what is the requester ID by this operator ID column. Okay. So now remote tracing. Just as an example, how to trace other operators session execution. Let me show you that. First of all, other operator should login with two IDs, two developer IDs. One we have already logged in, right? So this is the one who wanted to trace other person. This operator is the one who wanted to trace other operator. STFM admin IMPL, this operator wanted to trace this operator. Wanted to trace other operator. This is the first time I'm using this wizard. Before I did not access this wizard, but same options are available as SMS as well. Next one, other operator. So if you want to log in with other operator, you can use Chrome browser or you can use same browser with private session. Otherwise, it will log into existing session. Do we have second developer operator for our application? STFM DevOps 2 is there. Is it there or not there? Now, get ready with activity which we wanted to run. Get ready with activity, first of all. What is the activity? Here, I wanted to run an activity. Activity to simply, which activity has more steps? This activity has two steps. So better I'll, so before we run it, go to admin studio using operator one session. Using operator one session, you have to go to admin studio. Where is admin studio? This is admin studio. So here resources and you have to go to requesters. Choose requesters. Here, you should be able to find out the requester of who has logged in. Did you find STFM DevOps 2? Find STFM DevOps 2. So here you go. And at the end of the STFM DevOps 2, trace. So that operator I am tracing now. Now tracer is open. Tracer is pointing to which operator? Other operator. Now run the activity using operator 2. Simply I am giving operator 2 and all, just making meaningful sense. Now go through the tracer. I think options are everything is selected, all predefined rule sets also. That is why it is tracing everything. Now you can see what is the activity. Activity to run. What is the name of the activity? Activity one. You find activity one is traced. Here you can see activity one is traced. So here activity one is executed by whom? Executed by STFM DevOps 2, but traced by traced at stfmimpl@admin.com. Admin.com's session. At this session, we have traced it. This is called remote tracing. See, if you want to trace any other requesters other than your session, then you have to use the concept of remote tracing. This is clear. So other than this, the other approach is, look at here, just for your information. The other approach is, without going to Admin Studio also, you can trace. How to trace? So being here itself, Dev Studio itself. In the Dev Studio, you open the tracer generally. In the tracer, you need to click on remote tracer. Other way around, open tracer, click on remote tracer, click on remote tracer. So let me take 2 more minutes. Once you click on remote tracer, you'll see this window. So here you should find out the operators, this one, developer 2, right? You can see here. Okay, there you can see. Here it is, developer 2. The name of the operator is showing, not the ID. Developer 2, choose it from the drop down. Now say okay. Okay. Now run the activity. Before I'm going to run the activity, I'll make sure I don't want that OTP rule sets. Okay, you can run the activity now. Actions and then run the activity. Go through the remote tracer. Tracing happened, but remote tracing is being done. Tracer is opened at the session of operator, different operator. You can go to Admin Studio, from there you can trace, or you can go through normal tracer and click on the button remote tracer. From there, in the drop down, you have to find out the request name. So instead of request name, sorry, apart from request name, it will display requesters, sorry, instead of requester ID, it will display operator name also. From that you can easily identify. So this is just simply for your information going forward, which we are going to use in our development of when we are working with agents and all this we are going to use. Okay, so you can wind up for today. We'll continue tomorrow to work on agents.